Dear friends, we were all very shocked with the proceedings of yesterday and the manner in which Mr. Tarun Tejpal was found engaged in criminal activity was sought to be ignored. And addressing somebody from your own fraternity, so the victim is from your fraternity, whose father is also a journalist, and the accused and the criminal is also from your fraternity. And as if there's some sort of understanding that blanket needs to be put on this issue, while issue from other state, which is contrary to this particular episode, needs to be shown in poor light. In that case, the girl sought anonymity, wanted a closure to her past, doesn't want to relive her ordeal, and the state was approached to give her surveillance protection from a very powerful person, yet her name was being maligned and dragged onto the streets. I've come to know that today in some newspapers they have published the name, they have published the face of the girl. And I would wish that how many of you are going to publish Mr. Tarun Tejpal's ill deeds on the front pages, especially in a public place, a lift. And if anyone has read what the girl has gone through, in today's definition of the amended law, it is nothing less than rape. Sexual assault is what has happened to this young child, young girl. And the so-called atonement letter which has come is also shocking, because in that atonement letter, it's as if a paid holiday for 6 months is granted and the criminal actions can be covered in lieu of that. And that too, the wording of the letter is such, one, that there was misreading of the judgment. I don't understand. As a grown-up woman, misreading of the judgment means what? Is there a history to such actions? Or you're reading something which is not spoken? Or you thought that you could do something and get away with it? The second line, the second aspect, which is the crux of that so-called apology, is vacation of 6 months. Vacation of 6 months is not a punishment to an offense. And criminality cannot be shielded in this fashion. The other shocking thing which came forward is Tehelka, as a business house, as a news agency, as the newspaper, as a magazine, whatever one may call it, as an organization, does it have the policy of prevention of sexual harassment against women at workplace? And who are the members of the sexual harassment at workplace committee? Do they have an outsider on board? And have there been such acts even in the past which have gone unreported? The Press Council of India, the NCW, and also certain agencies seem to be not speaking on this issue, have maintained silence, and I think it needs to be taken up. The other aspect was that this particular complaint was sent to Ms. Shoma Chaudhary, who was very active in the during the discussions of Nirbhaya and amended law and all. We all worked very hard for those amendments. So if she's aware and she's a well-read person, as I assume, then if there is any knowledge about a crime which has happened, the first thing is to send that, share that knowledge and report the case to the police. That reporting seems to be missing. And in lieu of atonement, some cover-up seems to be underway. And if there is any sort of pressure on this girl who has shown the gumption of coming out in public, then we all need to support her cause and stand by her so that in future, no such things take place. The amended law, which stands today, the 375 in IPC, this is an offense under that, and equivalent to rape, because rape's definition itself has changed. I am on purpose trying to draw an ironical comparison between the two situations in which two different women are involved. One woman is seeking anonymity, and her reputation is being maligned by those who seek political vendetta. There are members from your fraternity who have been busy writing, designing, and organizing a slur campaign and violating her privacy. And there are members from your fraternity who are busy covering the acts of criminality. I think it's a wake-up call for us, both at political and social ends, and we all need to work at it, away from political vendetta, but seeking justice for women who suffer in such situations. The Congress and its surrogates have maintained certain silence, which also needs to be relooked. I heard some statement has come where the lady head of the women wing made a statement about those involved in criminal activities. 2/3 of her statement was about the state of Gujarat, which maybe overprotected the woman but did protect the woman from such activities which could have happened or happened. We don't want to get into that detail, that murky detail. But here, when a woman is undergoing all this, no help is coming out, and that help is what is needed. And this case needs to be taken to its logical conclusion so that a strong message across the board is sent. She made a statement about Gujarat. I want to ask her, there are 9 sitting MLAs in Rajasthan who have been found involved in rape and such rape and murder and sexual offenses charges. What is the stand of the party on those people? I don't want to go into the naming business, but definitely from the public knowledge, Malan Singh, Madarna, Babri Devi, these are Nagar, these are like public knowledge. These names have been doing rounds. And apart from the activities of certain ministers in the past and certain other spokespersons, etc., is also a public knowledge. So when these ladies make such statements, and when they have themselves gone to their chief that they are being violated within the party and so on, I think a larger sensitive approach to such issues, away from sensationalization, needs to be taken for political benefit. Certain issues of certain privacy cannot be sensationalized, and a sensationalized issue cannot be put under blanket. It can't be covered up.